Chatting with UNCP football head coach Shane Richardson after the Braves black and gold scrimmage and Gold Squad 110-9. But how nice is it just to get your team out there with a, kind of a game environment?
Oh, it's unbelievable. The competitive spirit was really high and on display tonight. We had talked about that all spring. That was something we wanted to accomplish. I really think we did that. It was great to see such a close game. I thought there were plays that were being made on both sides. A lot of great individual efforts, a lot of energy, you know, I thought, and it wasn't just a sloppy game. There wasn't just a ton of penalties or a ton of just bad, sloppy things. I mean, of course, there were some takeaways there, but I thought both teams really played hard, and I really like where we are coming out of tonight.
Did anything stand out to you? Did anything surprise you or any individual players kind of stand out?
You know, I don't know if I'm surprised. I think some guys got opportunities just because we had been going so much offense versus defense. And so now being able to split up the reps and go two teams, they got to be able to flourish in their roles. And, you know, so I think a lot of guys took advantage of that. I mean, you know, I don't know. I mean, I think there was just a lot of well-rounded play. Thought some DBs did a good job. You know, I got to give a lot of credit to the safeties. There were only three guys all night long that took every single rep. So they did a really good job with that. And there were some other positions that were thin, too, that I thought they just they played well because they had to play every single snap and they got a lot of opportunity. So, you know, I just like where we are as a team right now. And I thought there was a lot of really well-rounded things that took place out there.
And not just this game, but really the entire spring session, spring practice overall. How would you sum up how spring has gone and it culminating all tonight?
Well, I think we have a team that's hungry. I think they understand what took place last fall. And, you know, they understand what we've got to do to try to get back to some winning habits, really, to be quite frank. You know, we talked about this in the past, but, you know, winning is a habit and so is losing, and so you've got to be able to change some things and be able to develop new patterns and habits to be able to kind of replace that. And I think this spring was just a great opportunity for guys to understand you know, what's acceptable, what's not acceptable, what helps us win games, what doesn't help us win games. It's a simple concept, not easy to do. You got to get all 115 guys on the same page, and just everybody's got to believe, everybody's got to have the right mentality, everybody's got to execute it, you know. And so at the end of the day, there was a lot of work that was put in this spring to try to really transform the mentality, transform the culture a little bit, and be able to really go out and execute what we're trying to do. And so I really, really like how we did that this spring. And of course, there's a lot of work to be done in this offseason going into summer workouts and everything. And August will be here before we know it.
Like you said, you built competitiveness over the offseason or during this spring session. To see the guys' faces, there was guys that were heartbroken after the loss, more so than you normally see during a spring game. Is that you really feel like that's a byproduct of that?
I think it is. I think it is. And, you know, honestly, you know, I kind of just, you know, let them go. I mean, it's just, you know, I don't want them to I want them to feel the agony of defeat. I mean, because I think that means that they invested much and they were into it, they were engaged in it, and it shows just how badly each team wanted it. And so, you know, I was kind of you know, excited to see, if that makes sense, them actually feel as bad as they did for losing the spring game. And it means they care about it, and I think that's a really good quality. Of course, they're not very happy right now, but they'll get over it and they'll understand how important that is, because we don't want to have to go and feel that feeling when it really comes here in August and September, October, November.
Yes. So. Defensively, it was a low-scoring game. How do you feel like both units did? Obviously, the Gold Squad in the draft, they drafted some defensive guys early, and they really seemed to set the tone.
Yeah, I agree. I thought both defenses played very well. You know, and yet the thing was, there was still some things out there that were left on the field where, you know, there were some plays that we probably could have been better at. But I think both sides had takeaways, and both sides had sacks. Both sides had, you know, good run-stopping plays, and so a lot of hard hitting, a lot of guys flying around. I thought, you know, I was really proud of just the whole defense, just how it performed on both sides of the ball.
Talk a little about Roddy Smith. He looked pretty good out there running the option offense. Is that going to be a big part of your offense come fall?
Yeah, I think Rodney has a great opportunity here ahead of him. I mean, of course, you know, Josh Jones is, you know, a guy we know that, you know, is going to be on the field, but Rodney really showed some great things tonight. I think he does bring a different dynamic than Josh, obviously. Rodney's a guy that continues to embrace his role. He continues to show up every day. He continues to work and stay after practice. I'm really excited about what he can bring to the table, and we'll just have to see how that plays out. Comes August.
Did you think that he'd be good at a quarterback position?
Well, he was a quarterback in high school. We actually brought him here, changed him over to a receiver, and then didn't have enough scout team quarterbacks, and so he ran our quarterback position on scout team as an incoming freshman this past fall. And so after we got done with the season, we took a look at it and said, you know what, he can probably play that position for us. So he stayed there, and he's worked into the number two quarterback here, and I couldn't be more proud of just his attitude and the way he's embraced that opportunity.
The tight ends look really great out there too, Diab and Eller. Just talk about them, and they're making plays down the feet, down the sideline, across the middle, down the
Absolutely.
Seams.
What a great threat, when you have tight ends that can catch and can block and can run and can go up and get it. I think Fahim, over here, brings another element to the offense, and I think it really helps us to be a little bit more balanced and spread out and be able to use different weapons. So I really like those two guys. They've had a great spring, both of them.
Secondary looked really good out there today. They got hands on a lot of balls today. Let's talk about their performance tonight.
Yeah, I agree. I thought the corners did a great job. Safeties, we talked about a little bit. They were a little bit gassed, but still a very solid performance. Those DBs got a lot of reps all spring, so they should have been, kind of primed for this opportunity. So it was really good to see them make plays on the ball, absolutely.
Lastly, talk about your offensive line, how they look tonight.
Yep, I think we got some guys that can move some people. I think, we had one guy go down, and, the great thing is, I think only one guy did go down tonight. So, there was some good performances on the O-line. That unit has really gelled together well. They have done some really good technical work this spring to be able to just move their game forward. And just excited about, Gage Baldwin's a leader on the offensive line, and he's really embraced that role well and been leading those other younger guys, and they've really come together well.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.